communicates with prisoners and their families every day, I believe, even on holidays. So would you like to say a few words? Because you, she's probably the most, one of the most knowledgeable people on prison issues that I know. So, and she lives right here in Vienna. That makes her a good guy.
Yes, it isn't fair. Yeah. I did not dress to be on the panel today, but I don't know what I can add. I get about 50 letters a week, and I don't answer them all right away. And I get letters from some of the people that Gay has spoken of as well. And our issues are not only solitary, there are all kinds of issues, medical neglect, abuse, the cost of telephone calls. Now we have visitation issues because they're taking away a lot of privileges because of fear of drugs being imported. I guess I just want to say is that over the years I've learned the importance of working in coalitions. Virginia Cure has been around since 1992, and over those years we've had coalitions with many other organizations. And I think that's a very effective way to get things done, because you really can't do it by yourself. So it's wonderful to be here with Gay, who is just so logical and rational and just outlines it all and puts it in order, and to listen to Kimberly's passion and her story. And I think that's, I'm so glad, and John, of course, who keeps going and going and going. Thank you for asking me to speak.
My nickname's gonna be the Energizer Bunny, but basically we got involved in the, SALT got involved in the issue when we worked with a coalition, because women in prison that were pregnant were, they were shackled. So we got involved in an anti-shackling coalition, which was successful in getting it stopped. And I said to Patrick Hope, I said, what are we going to do next? And he said, he was going to take on solitary confinement. And I said, we had a bill drafted to, I said, that's good, let's go. But he said, well, the Virginia way is incremental. We'll have to put in a bill to study it. And then when the study results are in, then we'll put in some legislation. So I went along with that. We put in the bill to study it. And of course, it went to the Killer Committee, where they set up five or six subcommittees with five legislators. It only takes three, a quorum, to kill it, which they did. They scrubbed it immediately. So I went to Patrick and I said, what the hell are we gonna do? They killed it. They won't even study it. How can we do anything? He said, well, let's go see the Director of Corrections. And that got the momentum started for the step-down program. The fact is that there's a lot of good has come out of the step-down program. Supposedly, if they can set goals, they can reduce their time and set another goal and reduce it. But we find, like in the case of Kimberly here, her son is in there from 2013 to 2017. In fact, we got Patrick negotiated that we would get to go to Red Onion, and at the last minute, they wouldn't allow any of us to go along. They only allowed a couple prisoners, but I asked him when he came back what he learned, and he said, I met one guy that was in solitary for 14 years. I mean, you talk about going crazy. If you saw the segment on 60 Minutes last Sunday, my God, she said she spent one day in it, and she almost went crazy. Can you imagine how quickly a person deteriorates their mental health? You can go in mentally healthy and come out, we've been pushing for a 15-day limit, but they, they have related to you, they find ways around that. They certainly violate that, and so that's what we're working on, and that's kind of why we're looking at legislation. We found that New Jersey has a bill that's really excellent, but it was passed in New Jersey big time, but the Governor Christie vetoed it, so it's we know that it's a uphill road. So, we've all spoken our minds up here, and we'd like to hear from you. Any questions? And can you speak loudly? And if the audience has a